This is the fifth video in this pool table series, and in the first four videos we modeled this much of the corner pockets, and may not seem like much, but we're actually a lot closer than it may appear. We're going to start off by setting up some materials. So we'll come down and go into the materials panel. I'll add a new material. I'll give it a name. And the first one we'll do is pocket. So we'll make a pocket material. And we'll set a quick color and not spend any time on the colors because they're not very important at all. Then another material. This one we'll call wood. Again, set up a quick color for that, and we don't really need to spend any time at it. The exact color is not important. Then we'll add a third material. This one we'll call rail or rails. Set a color for that. And one more material, which will be the felt. So we'll call that felt. Set a quick color for that. And hopefully those colors won't look too funny. But it doesn't really matter. For the felt material, we're going to reduce specularity and hard right now and get that out of the way. And we're going to do the same thing on the rails, because those will be a fabric material, so they shouldn't be glossy at all. And then we're going to assign these. So we'll go into faces, return to the editing buttons, select all, and let's do the pockets first. So we'll select all and then deselect areas, because that's pretty much the easiest way to do the pockets. So I'll select the wood, rails, felt, and this is portion of the rails, and this is wood, whoops, and then we got one that's a little bit hidden down here. Hopefully we can get that to turn off. Let's try from underneath, maybe a little easier there. There it is. So we'll get those other sections of the pocket selected. And that's the pockets. We'll want to include that angled piece here. Not forget that. So we'll just assign the pocket material to that. Deselect that. So the A key. Select the region along the bottom. That'll be the felt. So brush select that. Assign the felt material there. And then the rails, which is only four faces. We'll assign a material there. Rails. And then the wood. And then that one underneath. Let's get that one selected. There it is. And we'll assign the wood to that. And the reason for assigning materials will come in more clear later. While we're in faces mode, there's actually a selection on the corner pocket that we need to duplicate. But first off, we're actually going to have to go into vertices. We'll set our cursor to the center of the corner pocket, so we'll snap our cursor there, and then go back into faces. And we're going to select a region here, the rails, where it joins to the pocket, and this angled triangle on the pocket. And we're going to look at that from the top view, change our pivot to 3D cursor by pressing the period key, shift duplicate that selection, drop it where it's at, and then mirror it along X. That's going to flip it around. We'll drop it there, Then we're going to rotate that by 90 degrees. So we'll rotate it 90 degrees. And that'll set it in place on the other side of the corner. We can then select all and remove doubles. Removing doubles is always a good idea. And that'll join those duplicate parts up with that side of the pool table. We need to do that because when we mirror this, that area is not going to be mirrored with the entire section. I'll quickly check on my time and see how much I have left and what we can get done now in this video. So I'll be back in just a second. Well, we still got a bit of time left, so I'm going to go into vertices mode. Look at this whole unit from a top view. Deselect all and select just the corner pocket area. So we'll select a corner pocket, and now we're going to set up some scale. When we moved the corner pocket up, we moved it by 20 blender units. So that means that we need to grab that along Y and move it by an additional 72 units. So we'll move that up by 72 units, and that'll set up the scale of our table. In terms of length, anyways. And that's from the wiki numbers I showed in the first video, where we had a length of 92. Now I'll select all, grab it along X, and move it by 46. And that sets the scale along the horizontal line. Now, 92 by 46 is a massive, massive size in a pool table. And if we looked at it through our camera, it would be clipping right out of view as though the curvature of the earth was affecting it. That's because this is actually a landscape scale. Now, we could change the clipping level on the camera, or we can just scale this down. So what I'm going to do is scale it down. First off, I'll center my cursor onto the origin. Keep my pivot in 3D cursor. And I'm going to scale that by a factor of 0.1. And now that looks tiny, but in reality it's 9.2 blender units by 4.6. And the way that's going to affect the scale of the balls is, rather than 2.25, they'll be 0.225. So the next thing to do is to mirror this assembly onto the other side. So we'll shift duplicate it, drop it where it's at, mirror along X. And that'll place the table or pockets onto the other side. And they'll carry all of the materials, which saves us a lot of work. And that's why we've attached materials already. And I'm probably pretty much out of time. In the next video, we're going to finish up by creating our rail and table edge on this side. That's going to go pretty quick. And then we're going to mirror for the other half of the table. So that'll be in the next video. And until then, happy modeling.